Welcome to our fourth biannual Advances in Geomatics Research Conference. All protocols are, we are happy to have you here and we hope for a very fruitful conference. Nancy Kayondo, I teach in the Department of Geomatics and Land Management and I will be the chair for this first session. I hope we all have a program and we can see that the first session is mainly about opening the program. We have one keynote address. We shall have a group photograph. We shall then break off for tea and then begin the second session where we shall have another keynote address and some more presentations. So without wasting a lot of time, I would like us to go through our opening ceremony, first by inviting the chair of the local organizing committee, Dr. Anthony Kidudu. Dr. Anthony Kidudu is the head of the geomatics department, which is the main host for this conference. Dr. Kidudu, you're welcome.
Thanks, Lydia. Very good morning to you all, and it's nice to see you here this morning, Thursday morning, as we commence our conference on advances in geomatics research. And it gives me great pleasure to announce that Mr. Mona is here, the director of research and projects training, Makerere University, and so the issues that we're discussing here are issues that are close to him. And we're glad that you make time to be here. And we have a panel of my bosses here, Professor Moses, Professor Henry, and our guest speaker, Professor Peter Bowman from, I used to read it as Jacobs University, but he says it is Jacobs University. And we booked him 2 years ago. And we are glad that he has going to come. We began this geomatics week. We began the geomatics week Monday, where we had a CPD, Continuous Professional Development course. We did it in conjunction with the Institution of Surveyors in Uganda. And it was about GNSS for professionals, and we had one of the facilitators, Dr. Ronald Semedo, and Professor Winsler. I think when you're dealing with our funders, Sida Sarek especially, you have to inform them that it is one of the main success stories we have as far as the institution is concerned, then he's here. And his work, he was running some of the GPS machines that we use. So it's one of the success stories we are proud of. And we also had an introduction to QGIS, open source. Many people who have been doing GIS would probably know about that GIS attribute. So we have QGIS, which is up and coming. And as Alan Nazimi was one of the people who was facilitating that workshop. And one of the things about Professor Bowman is that he's on the Open Geospatial Consortium, which holds standards for open source. And we are very privileged to have him here, you know, for the students, the GIS students, the students, who have had some of those standards and we have one of the architects of those standards. So it is a very big privilege for us to have him here. Yesterday we had a public lecture by Professor Schwein from geography, and it was a very, very enriching discussion that we had. Of course, this would not have been possible without the support of our sponsors and partners. We've had a couple of sponsors here who have been who have supported us. I would like to make special tribute to Data Grid. As we say, this is the fourth conference. And in each and every one of those conferences, he has we're grateful for that support, and we will have a brief session in the afternoon. I'd also like to mention Gio Gecko, who Bernard Bright is here. They are sponsoring a, we call it a hackathon, GIS for refugees, where we encourage students to come together and make sense of data, different data sets, and tell us a story about refugees, how we can solve their issues, their challenges. And the prof, I think, it's a very generous prize. 1.5 million for the first, for the best cost, $500. And we're grateful for that suggestion. And he will be giving a keynote address as well. And we will also have our very own Professor Moses give a keynote address for this question. And we will also have Dr. James Education. I think she has not yet come, but she will be here the next session after this. Like I mentioned, Professor Bowman is the professor of Big Data. Buzzword these days. He's one of those who has been at the forefront of that. And having him here is, I think, in your life, it's a scoop. It's a big one. And we're grateful that he has been able to be here. First time to Uganda. I don't know if it's the first time to Africa. You say the last time he came was to Egypt, but we know the building of Uganda in Africa. So we would say it's the first time in Africa, has been to Uganda. And we pray that it will be memorable. And Prof. at his own initiation, he proposed that he would like to meet PhD students. So we have scheduled a session with them at 4. So if there are PhD students, that's when I can see you there. Hopefully, Alan is somewhere nearby. And other PhD students, we have contacted the both of the great Bright Project. We will have a one-on-one with him. And have a conversation and hopefully give some guidance that we can use for. He's here very briefly, so let's make the most of this opportunity. He came last night and he's going tomorrow, so we have agreed that this should be the first of many more visits. And hopefully we shall, by the end of this time, have a fruitful collaboration that we are planning on. So with those few words, I would also like to recognize the other sponsor, SAPNET. Isaac is here. And Tom, what did you think about SAPNET? That these are our students who are going up into industry, form the companies, and then now supporting us. And we'd like to have more of these happening in subsequent conferences. Yeah, so with those few words, I would like to invite move higher up. Thanks, a big man director, so we shall go and see this. Thank you very much, and we will have a fruitful conference.
Thank you very much, Jim, for being here. Allow me also to invite my boss to say one word or two. Protocol Search, our guest of honor. Principal said that, who is also today, I think, acting as the deputy vice chancellor in charge of finance and administration. And our guest from FAB, Professor Peter Roman. Sponsors, invited guests, and our students who are here. The head of department has already explained about geopolitics and also about the importance of this conference. But maybe one thing I would like to add is that many times when we talk about conferences, we talk about big things like five-star hotels and so on. And last week I was in Nairobi and being invited for a conference. But many of the professors, more especially those who can think from abroad, they are complaining that when they were invited to the University of Nairobi, they wanted to go and see the real environment university where people work from. And if possible, we interact with the students and we go to the lecture rooms. But we are in a five-star hotel, which to them looks like an official environment as far as the issues of geomatics in that country were concerned. So here, I would like to think and thank the Department of Geomatics to bring geomatics to the university. I know, given that there were many sponsors, of course, they were not sure to go to Serena Hotel or any other hotel. But now here we are in our environment. This is where we actually work from. So this is good because the cost is not so much a problem. It's affordable to many of our people. So I thank you for that. With those few words, let me invite the principal president to come and also to the
leadership. I would like to stand on the protocol already observed by Dr. Kidu and to say you are most welcome, especially to our keynote speaker from Germany, the director. Directors of Research and Development Training, who is the guest of honor this morning. Our dear participants, students, people from industry, and the members of the members of staff. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the organizers of this conference. I know organizers have been involved in organizing conferences, but it's not an easy thing. Even if it's a meeting for 110 people, there are always issues, the logistics, troubles, you know, schedules. So it's not a mean achievement. So I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the organizers. I'd also like to thank the sponsors and supporters of this. And I would like on this note to recognize the contribution of the Presidential Initiative. Therefore, we thank the President for supporting us in very many ways. The other day, I posted something on our Senate webmail, and you must have realized what contribution the President is making toward the success of this university and this college in question. My hope is that this conference, this meeting is going to address the challenges, the global challenges that we are facing, and also, you know, societal challenges, the things that will be useful to the day-to-day person. My colleague has talked about big data, media. I know the issues of we know about surveying in the various ways, remote sensing, GIS, but all those should be used to influence decisions on human behavior and interaction with the environment. These days there are issues of global warming, there are issues of water resources, lakes drying up. So I hope that what we are doing will be able to address those issues of facing the globe, but also the issues that are pertinent to the day-to-day use by the wananchi, by the local users. So, mine is really to welcome you and to assure you of our support as a college and as a university. My colleague has introduced me as the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Finance and Administration. I'm there for 3 days already. And excuse me when you see me moving out, because I've just been informed there's another meeting, a meeting of council which I need to go and attend. I would have loved to be here longer. And to act with our colleagues from Japan and elsewhere. So let me stop here so that I don't make the opening remarks too long. And it's too long. Recently, I was in Nigeria for a conference, and we spent more than half of the first day just on introductions and protocol. And so that shouldn't happen here. So thank you very much. At this juncture, I would like to invite our guest of honor to bless us.
Vice Chancellor of Finance and Administration, the keynote speaker of the event, Professor Peter Bowman, my colleague, the Dean School of Built Environment, Professor Moses Musinguzi, our chair organizing committee, Professor Antoine Gidudu, the whole organizing committee, representatives from government, private sector, and government partners here present. We sincerely very welcome to this event. On behalf of university management, it is a great pleasure to welcome you to the fourth biannual conference on advances in idiomatics research, 2017. In a special way, it gives me a pleasure to welcome you, especially colleagues and collaborators who have traveled from afar to join us. And of course, I welcome all colleagues from the university community who have come to partner with the Department of Geomatics and Land Management at this very important occasion. Of course, the theme of the day is in tune with our national vision and research agenda, that is addressing our societal challenges using geomatics. This theme is, of course, of strategic success, and it fits in well with our vision for humanity in this country and globally. For participants that are attending for the first time, I'm alive to the fact that this conference builds on the success as learned from the previous three conferences held in 2011, 2013, and 2015. I would like to congratulate the department for pioneering this conference series and for keeping the momentum of geomatic discourse and narrative and scholarship in general. Here in the College of Engineering and Technology, for colleagues that are not familiar with the geography and the functions of this university, you are at the center of Uganda's geospatial and geomatic information industry. And you'll note that since 1980s, we have been using your spatial information systems in a variety of different ways and fields, including land administration, natural resource management, utility asset management, disaster assessment and management, and most recently, automobile, GPS and web-based mapping systems. So it is, of course, it was a strategic decision that we decided to hold this conference here. The conference is about building on the efforts of the previous conferences. It is about exploring the wide range of possibilities that geomatics and geospatial technologies has to offer, and it's about finding ways to improve the lives of the ordinary community through the use of these technologies. Evidently, colleagues, it is at such forum that we get to share the research and also keep abreast about the latest developments in our professions and disciplines. Indeed, it is the activities of such nature that contribute to the university's scholarship. And this is why we have positioned ourselves not only as the best university in the region, but also offering research leadership. And I sincerely applaud and salute the department for keeping this scholarship alive. Undoubtedly, Makerere is a major source of various homegrown innovations and technologies that are contributing to the transformation of society. Many of these groundbreaking innovations have been hatched through activities such as this one. Under the Makerere Geospatial Geomatics Strategy, we will continue to encourage meaningful communication, collaboration, and commitment with the sister institutions. And I sincerely thank the department for identifying those credible and dependable institutions. Coming to the theme of the conference, as a country and a region, we are facing several challenges, as the principal has alluded to, including floods, drought management, landslides, influx of refugees, climate change, land conflict, to name but a few. And whatever our disciplines as a university, we all have a moral duty to contribute to mitigation against these challenges. This conference, therefore, gives us the perfect forum to reflect on these challenges and see what role geomatics can play in remedying and mitigating the challenges that affect humanity in general. For Makerere University and comes at large. This means putting particular emphasis on research and government initiatives. In fact, our science in this department of geomatics, I'm aware that I have long standing and important scientific experience in research and the research function affecting these challenges that we are facing. As we look for the future, particularly at the 2030 national time vision, geomatics is a set of processes and functions that will, of course, manifest differently, that will manifest differently in different places. Oftentimes, not targeted, but definitely, we are contributing to national development in many various ways. We all realize the positive impact that geomatic capabilities have here. It is time we bring the academia and industry together to make the shared vision a reality. Before this formal meeting, I had an informal interaction with Professor Peter Bowman, and we discovered that there is no second guessing. It's all about attacking the challenges as of now, and the situation and the timing is today. I would like to take this opportunity to sing out our development partners and supporters, particularly the chair organizing committee, Professor Anthony Kidudu, has alluded to this. I've been informed that Geo Gecko, a partnered with the department to host the GIS for refugee hackathon. Okay? The idea of inspiring our students beyond the confines of what they learn in class to using knowledge gained to address such pertinent issues is what spurs innovation. And this is our strategic vision as the Director of Research and Graduate Training at this university. It is heartwarming to note that as a department, you have partnered with many institutions, including the Institution of Surveyors of Uganda, to run continuous professional development courses. As professionals, you know better more than I do that you need to continuously upgrade yourselves in tune with the first gen technology and national requirements. It is gratifying to note that professional organizations such as ISU have come up to leverage the expertise we have at the university to this effort, and I would like to suggest that in the future you need to partner with many other professional organizations, including the Uganda Institute of Physical Planners, the Uganda Institute of Professional Engineers, for I can see opportunity and synergies with these institutions. The conference papers that I've just perused through show the rich diversity of academic background and how cross-disciplinary geomatics and geoinformation can be. The rich diversity of papers we are yet to receive today and tomorrow address a number of human challenges, including health issues, traffic accidents, environmental concerns, agriculture application, even the economy as a whole. Clearly shows the pivotal role geomatics and geospatial technologies play in society. And this conference is a clear testimony that we are up to tune and prepared to address these challenges. I look forward to seeing the special issue of the African Geographical Review published by Taylor and Francis, as it is an important outlet to enable us to showcase to the world our solutions to the problems that face us today. I must also give the organizers credit for making it possible for the undergraduate and even graduate students to present their work at international conferences of this nature through oral and poster presentations. This is a rational pathway, okay, to nurturing the next generation of African academics, and I sincerely congratulate you. Once again, I welcome you to Makerere University, especially our partners that have traveled from Accra, and wish you fruitful deliberations as you address the various judges, remote sensing, land management, and other relevant issues in the industry. To this end, I want to say that it is my sincere wish that you take advantage of this forum to exchange scientific ideas, inspire inspire new research, result in new contacts for closer cooperation, because this is the way and it is our vision for internationalization of Makerere as a university. With that, I would like to sincerely appreciate the generous contribution of the keynote speakers about MEC, the paper reviewers, the sponsors, exhibitors, and all of you that have come to participate in this important event. As I conclude, I would like to thank the members of the department and the organizing committee in particular that have worked tirelessly to organize this conference. It is now my singular duty and pleasure to declare the fourth conference on advanced idiomatics research 2017 open. Thank you very much.